know in RTE1, Chris and Tony work hard, but Harry pays the price in Shortland Street.
A sly one. I already turned him down.
You don't want to publicise the fact that we're doing world-beating surgery.
Frank Eastwick, I spoke with you on the phone earlier.
If you're angling for an interview, I'm afraid that won't be possible.
Would you prefer to see me get it wrong, all over the front page?
This hospital has big problems, management problems.
Oh, that is it.
My father was a pompous, domineering old coot, but he taught me a lot about the way hospitals should be run. And I, for one, will not sit around and watch you drive this place into the ground.
Fights with who here, okay?
I was making a point, that's all.
What's your feed list today?
Busy.
Great.
Have you seen my mobile?
It's on the bench.
Well, I looked on the bench.
Yeah, boy, look, have a proper look.
I'm telling you, it's not on the bench. Found it.
Look.
I'll get it.
All right, we need to grab milk and bread tonight, too.
Okay. Margaret, sorry, we're still at the madhouse stage.
No worries.
Hiya, Harry.
I made a fort.
Chris, we're going to be late.
I'm waiting on you. Oh, thanks for taking him to school.
Our chefs are a nightmare. We might need you later in the week too, if that suits.
That's fine.
Harry, you were supposed to eat that and get ready for school.
I can't find his bag.
It's behind the chair.
Oh, look behind the... Oh, down it.
We're gonna have to run. Harry, look what you've done.
Mate, not helpful.
Oh, we'll clean it up. You go. Oh, thanks, Margaret. My mate. Have a great day, okay?
Yeah, cause lots of trouble.
Very funny. Bye.
See you later.
Oh, please. Get this. Representatives of the prisoners claim that the hunger strike will last for as long as it takes the authorities to act upon their demands.
What do they want now?
Oh, plasma screens, broadband.
Same as before, I guess. Reduce overcrowding, improve conditions.
It's that bad. Why starve themselves as well?
Because they're really, really stupid and they love the limelight. Ooh, tea's hot. Do you want some?
Ta.
What's happening?
Oh, that scumbag Cartney didn't get enough attention with the hospital siege, so now he and his mates are hunger striking.
Oh, right.
Milk with one, black. Alice?
No, I'm fine.
These are the same guys that got knocked around with food poisoning. I wouldn't want to punish my body after that. It must be serious.
Seriously hungry without three taxpayer-funded meals per day. I give them 48 hours tops.
I guess that's one way to check how committed they are.
Hand over.
How's your first day back at work?
It's okay.
Good. Don't let Sarah get you down. Just do your job.
I will. Total focus.
Have faith in yourself.
Yeah, it's a bit hard sometimes, eh? And people you respect don't.
Yeah, I guess we just have to keep proving ourselves. People judge actions, not words.
True enough. Thanks.
Thank you.
Kia ora.
Good morning.
I wanted to say sorry. Now, you're right. I should have told you about Maggie having you watched. I was a bit shocked, I guess.
Okay.
And if you're still mad at me, that's fine. But maybe at work, we could let bygones be bygones.
Fair enough. You know, I've been thinking about what happened. About why Maggie chose me as the way to keep me under control.
Oh, could have been a few people, I guess.
Yeah, but it wasn't. It was me.
Oh, who knows how Maggie thinks. He was that out of it.
Tony thinks there might be a more personal reason.
Maybe. I should get going.
Tony thinks that Maggie must have thought you were keen or something.
Oh, no offence, but like I said, Maggie had a few crazy ideas.
So do you feel bad now he's in prison?
Sad.
Friends no more, eh?
Nah. Not after what he did. Not after what he threatened to do.
Okay. Truce established. Let's go back to work.
You'll never guess. The boss just begged me to do the interview with that journalist.
Oh, smart girl.
It was my idea.
Yeah, I meant her getting you and him on side. Two birds, one stone.
I knew that.
Yeah. Hey, what was with
with Harry's tanty this morning?
Oh, no idea. Maybe he's coming down with something.
Well, unless he's upset about the new school.
Please, no. We're not going back there, are we?
I wasn't about to knock your precious St. Bart's. I was just saying, maybe he's having trouble settling in.
Okay, yeah. Maybe we should call his teacher.
Oh, and Margaret rang. She can't pick him up for school. We'll have to do it.
Okay.
Craig, good luck with the interview.
Ah, full house, eh?
I'll be out here in a minute.
Okay, hunger strike management. Someone starving themselves?
No, just interested.
Curious interest, I'd say. Count on it. Our friends at Balmoral Prison won't be coming to Shortland Street for treatment.
Just wondered about prognosis, that's all.
Depends how it's managed.
Force feeding, you mean?
Yep. Strap them down, whack in a nasogastric. Taking what precautions?
Check placement via pH testing and stethoscope.
pH testing's usually enough. Either way, we taxpayers get to foot the bill for their stupid little stunts.
Hunger strike is hardly a stunt. Multi-organ atrophy, fatigue, mental deterioration, death.
It's what they deserve.
They're human beings. How'd you feel if it was your dad? They messed up, yes. But they're someone's father or son. They don't deserve freedom, but they do deserve dignity.
And what about the dignity Cartney robbed from that young girl when he and his mates pack raped her? Or is that okay with you too?
Well, I'm glad we're finally getting the chance to set the record straight.
I'm very confident we can.
But just in case, for the record.
Fair enough. Shall we kick off?
Please.
Well, Shortland Street seems to have had more than a share of problems lately.
The hostage crisis certainly put our systems to test.
Yes, then there was the prisoner outpatients contract that put the staff under pressure, widening of the catchment.
Issues now fundamentally resolved.
To your satisfaction?
Yes.
If not to that of your staff. It must help to have a medical background in terms of understanding staff issues.
Actually, I'm not medically trained. My background is in management.
Oh, I'm sorry. I assume that you've been CEO at Shortland Street, yes?
That's correct.
Is it useful to be a hands-on practitioner when running a hospital in terms of understanding the issues fully?
We work as a team. So, for example, I consult others on their expertise just as Huia consults me on mine.
And your expertise is in the business side of things?
Yes.
Now, you were first hired as business manager, and when Andrew Solomon made his sudden departure, you were thrust into the hot seat.
I was appointed acting CEO.
And yet when a permanent appointment was made, you were put to the post by Dr. Godfrey, yes?
Your point is...
Well, you were overlooked in favour of a medical person. So why then did the DHB decide you were the right person for the job?
Well, you really should ask them.
Or perhaps I can ask Dr. Warner. Obviously the DHB has confidence in Ms. Samuels. Does her staff?
Well, I can only speak for myself.
Of course. So tell me. Do you respect your CEO? Trust that as a non-medical person, she will make sensible and informed decisions on your behalf.
How's your query at Dopane?
She seems convincing. Her pulse and BP are up, but she could be strung out. Pregnancy test is negative, urine's okay. She claims she's on holiday from Christchurch and she looks like a junkie. When I offered her antacid, she got cranky, same with paracetamol.
Did you ask her GP's name?
She says she hasn't got one.
And bowel sounds?
Fine, everything's fine, except she's in agony.
And you want my opinion because?
Because I want to check if I've covered the bases.
Well, you have. Now decide if she's faking.
How? Assess the efficacy of antacids, then minor pain relief.
Mm-hmm. Exclude all other diagnoses, and then ask her if she has substance abuse problems, and then watch her run. Miracle recovery. Hallelujah.
Right. You don't mind if I check this with you, do you?
Go forth and heal.